I'm going to show you how to schedule different staffing levels for different locations in one schedule. Here we have a schedule, and my different locations are indicated by different colors here. Now, each location you would have names obviously beside these locations, but each ones have different staffing requirements. So let's run the schedule. And you're going to get a dialog box. And let's just do location one for starters. And let's say we need 6 people, and they're required to work 5 shifts this month. And so what we're going to do is enter shifts and close this box. And you can see that we now have the staffing for location one calculated. So let's clear the schedule, and let's say that we're going to be doing location one and location three. So we're going to run the schedule again and get our user form coming up. And so we're going to be going 6 and 5. And then let's go for location four, or location three, let's go 4 and 4. And then location four, we're going to go 4 and 4 as well. Okay, and let's enter shifts. And then let's close the dialog box. And now you can see that we have scheduled everybody for these three locations that we've selected. We need to have 2 people working at all times, and here we do. We're short for these. At the end, we have calculated the number of people working weekends. And so there's our 1 and 2. The 2 is the maximum. And so let me show you what the code looks like. And so I have a dialog box up, and this is a user form. And so each of the first box, which is the number of people, I've called it R1, and it'd be R2, R3, R4. And then, so that's the number of people required. And the second box is named R1S, which is this level and how many staff do they require. So let's right click on enter shifts, and then we will see the code. Okay, so for each one, I have declared for one, I've said A, and A required, and A required staffing. And so I've done the same for all the way down until E. So we have the 5 levels. Now I have calculated the date as the start date, as from these cells on this is the start date and this is the end date. And I've calculated the difference here. So what we have here is we have start date equals this cell, end date equals that cell. And then we have EX, which is the extent of the days, is end date minus start date plus 1. For each of those, I have, if it has nothing in it, then we're going to go to the next one and see if it has something in it. But if it does have something in it, then I'm going to say, so for A1, A equals R1 plus text, I'm just selecting where the line starts, of the code. And then I'm saying ARS, that's the number of staff we have, is this cell here, whatever it has in there. And the staffing requirements equals the total number of days divided by the number of staff that are required. Okay, so now let's go down. And so that's the same for each one of those. And now I'm going to go down to the actual putting the W's on the form. And I'm going to say, once again, I'm saying if it's blank, then go to the next one. And do while I, which is the row number, is less than or equal to A, which is the number of that we calculated is the number of line. And then I go sheet 1, cells I3, select. And then I'm going, if Z is less than, so if the number of days is less than the total days, then, and if this active cell has nothing in it, then we're going to put a W in it. and I continue that for each of the shifts. I will, of course, include this code in the description of my video. Is this going to work for your organization? Let me know below. Please subscribe.